On the Nature Trail with Lindsay Webb. Brought to you by New Hampshire Fish and Game's Wildlife Journal.
Eastern coyote, adaptable predator now widespread in New England. The moon was full, and I could hear the cricket chorus of early fall on the soft breeze as I strolled to the pond. As I meandered through the ghostly trees on my late night walk, an eerie and beautiful howl pierced the night air. The sound seemed to bounce off the hills and echo back. I stopped and listened, and heard another long howl, this time coming from somewhere else, the direction I was headed. There was more howls, each sending shivers up my back, making me imagine what those before us must have felt when they heard howls in the night. But I moved on, closer, hoping to get a look at the creatures making this night music. As I approached the pond, the moonlight was bright enough for me to easily see a group of coyotes at the edge of the water. Coyotes are very social animals and are often seen in pairs or family groups. Tonight, they seem to be howling just for the pleasure of it. Or they may have been communicating with younger animals out learning new hunting skills. The eastern coyote is a relative newcomer to New Hampshire. The first sighting was in Holderness in 1944. Today, coyotes are found throughout New England in every available habitat, from rural to urban. So it's no surprising that they would be at the pond near my house. I knew they were coyotes and not domestic dogs by their howling, their size, erect pointed ears, and bushy drooping tail. As I watched them, I was struck by the array of colors, from creamy to dark rufous to tawny gray, that they could be seen even by moonlight. These were fairly typical eastern coyotes, with long, thick fur and weighing 35 to 50 pounds. The eastern coyote outweighs its western counterpart by 6 to 15 pounds, partly because the species bred with wolves and coyote wolf types. It is believed that in the 1800s, coyotes were pushed out of the Great Plains by efforts to eradicate them. They moved into Ontario, Canada, and interbred with wolves there. The resulting coyotes then spread throughout New York and New England. Coyotes mate only for a short time in February or early March. Females are receptive only 4 to 6 days a year. A short time before the pups are born, coyotes make a den. They may dig their own den or enlarge a burrow of a woodchuck, fox, or skunk. Some dens go straight back, while others go down. The den chamber is about 3 feet around and is kept clean by the adults. It is usually well concealed in a brushy slope, steep bank, rocky ledge, or dry culvert, or under a stump, hollow log, log pile, or deserted building. The pups are born 60 to 65 days after mating, with 4 to 8 pups in a litter. At birth, the pups are blind and helpless, covered with short, woolly hair, and weigh a half pound. They are nursed for about 2 weeks. The male of the adult pair hunts for the female, bringing her food to eat. She regurgitates it and then feeds it to the young. Coyotes are opportunists and will eat all sorts of things, depending on the time of year. In summer, they may eat fruits and berries, as well as insects and small mammals. In New England, they feed on rabbits, hares, voles, mice, and other small mammals. They also consume carrion of all sorts. In winter, when deep snow forces deer to slow down, coyotes prey on deer. In spring, they prey on fawns. In urban settings, adaptable coyotes are sometimes seen eating out of dumpsters. The coyotes at the pond seemed to sense my presence. Perhaps they got a whiff of my smell. After a few yips and a short howl, they move off into the forest. I reminded myself to come back tomorrow to see if I could find their oval-shaped tracks in the mud. I headed homeward too, snapping on my flashlight. As I crested the hill near the house, I stopped and listened again to the now distant howls of the coyote.